name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, welcome to gather here for this wonderful occasion and to celebrate together with Kristin and Kristin today. Please turn to 9:15 of the minutes left. Psalm 9:15 for the Gloria. Love fruitful, they may become by your grace witnesses to charity itself. Through Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for the reading.
A reading from the book of Tobit. On their wedding night, Tobiah rose from bed and said to his wife, "Sister, get up. Let us pray and beg our Lord to have mercy on us and grant us deliverance." Sarah got up and they started to pray and beg that deliverance might be theirs. They began with these words, "Blessed are you, O God of our fathers. Praise be your name forever. Let the heavens and all creation praise you forever. You made Adam and you gave him his wife Eve to be his help and support. And from these two, the human race descended. You said it is not good for man to be alone. Let us make a partner like himself. Now, Lord, you know that I take this wife of mine not because of lust, but for a noble purpose. Call down your mercy upon me and on her, and allow us to live together to a happy old age." Then they said together, "Amen, amen." The word of the Lord.
Amen. Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. The Lord is compassionate toward all his people.
The Lord is compassionate
through all his people. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works.
The Lord
is compassionate to all his works. Let all your works give us thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. The eyes of all look hopefully on you, and you give them their food in due season.
The Lord
is compassionate towards all his people. The Lord is just in all his ways and holy in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth.
The Lord
is compassionate
in all
to all his works. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, live in love as Christ loved us and handed himself over for us. Be subordinate to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives should be subordinate to their husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of his wife, just as Christ is the head of the church, he himself the Savior of the body. As the church is subordinate to Christ, so wives should be subordinate to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ loved the church and handed himself over for her to sanctify her, cleansing her by the bath of water with the word, that he might present to himself the church in splendor, without spot or wrinkle of any sort, that she might be holy and without blemish. So also husbands should love their wives as their own body. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no one hates his own flesh, but rather nourishes and cherishes it, even as Christ does the church, because we are the members of his body. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak in reference to the church of Christ. In any case, each one of you should love his wife as himself, and the wife should respect her husband. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Alleluia verse.
Is there for the gospel?
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Thank you.
If we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon again. On behalf of Father Damien and myself, Deacon Jr., we want to welcome you all to St. Lawrence Church. 57 years ago, on the morning of Emmy and I's wedding, it looked a lot like rain. I told my mother, it looked like we're going to have a yucky day for a wedding. My mother told me, "No, son, when you have rain on your wedding day, it means that you will have a long and happy marriage." Well, it turned out good for us, and I pray that it turns out good for you, too. Kristin and Baylor, wonderful. See so many people here today, family, friends. We share this blessed day and happy day with you, and of course, to witness your marriage. I'm deeply honored to be part of your wedding, because you're both special in Emmy's and my life. When a man and woman plan to marry in the Catholic Church, the couple is required to take a marriage preparation course. And this course is called POCUS. There are approximately 200 questions that deal with life, family, problem solving, and of course, the religious values. And when a couple disagrees on a question, it stimulates communication. And by the way, that is one of the many problems that many marriages face. I must tell you that Kristin and Taylor scored quite high on their overall knowledge of all these broad subjects. Will their knowledge of this course solve all the problems that they might face in a wedding and in the marriage? Probably not. But somewhere in their growing up years, someone had made a great impression on their religious values and their commitment to the covenant of marriage. Their commitment to love one another is quite evident and is rooted deeply in their faith. Kristin and Taylor, the day you've been making plans for, finally here. But all the planning and preparations you have been busy with, sometimes a few challenges step in the way. But how you handle those challenges is most important. I hope that the Christian values you have will remain in your hearts and continue to be the center of your marriage. The readings you have chosen for today are special, and I would like to comment on each reading. The first reading from the Old Testament, the book of Tobit. It's a very touching story of Tobit's son Tobias marriage to Sarah. And just a little background to bring you up to speed on this reading. Sarah lived in a different city, a long distance away. The journey is long, and Tobias needs someone to travel with him and to be his guide. decide to be sheriff is possessed by a demon named Osmodeus. This demon Osmodeus has killed 7 of Sarah's previous husbands-to-be before the wedding. Sarah is a God-fearing and faithful woman who is obedient to God. She is so depressed that she's to the point of self-destruction, but she continues to pray. Pi also has a strong faith and asks God for guidance on his journey. And on that journey, Raphael gives Tobiah a cure made from parts of the fish to burn with incense to remove the demon from Sarah. And Raphael instructs them to pray together in order for their marriage to be filled with divine love and to obtain all those special gifts of grace. That prayer is the reading Kristin and Taylor have chosen for today. There's so much more in this beautiful story. I urge you to dust off your Bibles and read it sometime. In the New Testament reading from St. Paul to the Ephesians, the dignity of a Christian marriage is compared to the union between Christ and his church. This reading, without doubt, is the richest text in the New Testament in regard to marriage. It relates to God's covenant with his people, with his love and his fidelity. And he renews this covenant with Christian spouses in the sacrament of marriage. St. Paul, in line with the customs of that time, tells the wives to be submissive to their husbands, and the husbands to be submissive to the wives. For they are bound to one another in one flesh through this unbreakable covenant. A covenant that Kristin and Taylor are about to enter into. In the gospel reading from John doesn't say anything about marriage, but it definitely does give us a guide how to live a Christian life. And it is also one of God's commandments: love one another as I have loved you. Jesus is speaking this passage to his disciples shortly before his ascension to the Father. In a marriage, a man and woman are called to love one another with their whole heart. When you love that way, no matter what challenges your marriage faces, Jesus will be there for you. He will be there when your lives are troubled, as well as when your lives are filled with joy. He will be there for you in every crossroad of your life. He is here today, blessing your marriage. There's an old story I like to tell that kind of relates to love. 400 years ago, there was a ship that sank off the coast of Ireland. And a few years ago, some divers located this old ship and began bringing up some of the artifacts. And among some of the treasures they found was a man's wedding ring. When they cleaned all the salt and junk off of it, they found that it was a traditional Irish wedding ring. And inside of the band was an engraving of 2 hands holding a heart with a crown on the top. The hands mean friendship, the heart love, and the crown fidelity. And if you put all these things together, it means when I give with my whole heart, I have nothing more to give. And this ring meant more to the divers with its beautiful meaning than all the other artifacts that they pulled up from the ocean floor. But isn't that what love is all about? Spouses must give their hearts totally to one another. Marriage is not a 50-50 arrangement. It calls for 100% commitment. Anything less than that, and your marriage sinks like the ship in the story. Taylor and Kristin, help you give that 100%. Yeah, the most powerful force there is. That's Jesus Christ himself. the unconditional love Jesus has for you, combined with the love you have for one another, that creates a sound foundation for your love to continue to grow. But for this to happen, you need to be open to what God has to say to you. And I encourage you to pray often and pray together. The reward of a good prayer life is overwhelming. And you will discover that the strongest and happiest marriages have God at the center of them. And one final request of the family and friends gathered here today. You were invited here because Taylor and Kristin could not have come to this moment in their life without you. You've been a special part of their lives in some way, and your task is not yet finished. What Taylor and Kristin need from you is to know that you will be there for them always. They need your love. They need your support, and they need your prayers. By this continuing support, they will be living proof that God's plan for life together, till death do they part, will be a reality. Taylor and Kristin said a lot today. You don't need to remember it, and that's okay. But there are three things that you do need to remember. And you need to say them to each other as often as needed. And they are, I forgive you, I am sorry, and I love you.
Thank you.
offering our petitions with present confidence before him.
For our Pope Francis, our Bishop George Lucas, and all the men of the Church, that they may lead all of us to love one another as the Father loves us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of our country and all political leaders, that they continue to promote true justice and peace for all, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For the sick, lonely, and the poor people of the world, that through our prayers of love and concern, they will be blessed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have chosen marriage as their vocation, that their love for one another fosters growth and deepens the faith of all whom they meet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our relatives and friends gathered here, that they always share the faith, hope, and love they have with their families. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Taylor and Kristin, who begin their married life together this day, may they experience the love of God, the support of family and friends, and the blessing of children. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Richard Bauer, Joanne Maloney, Eugene Tungus, Mary Ann Tungus, and Odetta Berkey, and all who have died, may they know the peace and the fullness of eternal life with God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those intentions we found deep in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our loving Father, source of all love and all that is good, we thank you for bringing Taylor and Kristin together in a bond of marriage today. Protect them, look over them, care for them, and we ask these petitions through your Son, Jesus. We make this prayer through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the offertory.
Our offertory song is number 608, I Have Loved You.
I have loved you.
to be comforters, the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for to your goodness we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, to become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive me for your Lord, the offering made on the occasion of the sealing of the sacred bond of marriage, and just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony, an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, their rebirth and baptism gives increase to the church through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we are praying. Devotion are known to you, for though we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or the offering for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those who do not really venerate, especially the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, the spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. This oblation of our service, the offering of his servants, Kira and Kristin, and of your whole family, who entreat to your majesty on their behalf, and as you have brought them to their wedding day, so gladden them with your gift of the children they desire, and bring them in your kindness to the length of days for which they hope. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. And let us, we beseech you, into their company, not claim our merits, but grant us your pardon through Christ our Lord. through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to the Lord that on these his servants, now buried in Christ, he may mercifully pour out the blessing of his grace and make up one heart in love by the sacrament of Christ's body and blood, those he has joined by a holy covenant. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they might no longer be two, but one flesh, and taught that what you have pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery that in the wedding covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ and his church. O God, by whom woman is joined to man, and the companionship they had in the beginning is endowed with the one blessing, not forfeited by original sin, nor washed away by the flood. Look now with favor on these your servants, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of love and peace abide in your daughter, Kristin, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband entrust his heart to her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these your servants hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments, made one in the flesh. May they be blameless in all they do, and with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all. May they be blessed with children and prove themselves virtuous parents who live to see their children's children, and grant that, reaching at last together the fullness of years for which they hope, they may come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord. The peace, Lord, be with you always.
Our communion song is number 349, I am the bread of life. Number 349.
I am the bread of life.
executed, dressed to make of one heart and love, though severally joined in this holy union, and replenished with the one bread and the one chalice, through Christ our Lord. Before we end this wedding month, we have a special blessing for both Taylor and Kristin. May God, the eternal Father, keep you of one heart in love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home. Amen. May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone. Amen. May you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God.
Amen.
And may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Kristin Dahl.